Hey guys, how's it going? JD here, wrapping up another easy money trade. It's 6:14 in the morning, and this will be my second one. You know, so I'll grab my little 200 for the day, and I'll be calling it a day. Probably gonna get back into bed, because like I said, it's 6:14 in the morning. We've already, you know, made some decent money for daily trading. So another easy money trade. We got, what, 28 seconds here. We'll be able to do our countdown. It's my favorite time of day, getting that countdown knocked out. And again, you know, my personal goal is I just like to grab 200 a day. You know, if I can snatch 200 a day out the market, you know, that's pretty good. So let's roll with it. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Say it with me.
Easy money.
Hey guys, how's it going? JD here. So in this video today, we're going to learn how to consistently win breakout trades. Now, many of you probably know I typically don't like breakout strategies. All right. Most breakout strategies do not work. And it's simply because they're not taught properly. Okay. You actually can take breakout trades if you take it the right way. So I was just doing some studying and I came across this trade that was called the Last Kiss. And as I was reading about the setup, I was just like, I know exactly what this is. And I know it as the breakout pullback entry. And so for those of you who have been following me from the beginning of this channel, I mean to tell you, if you don't know, those who've been here know. But if you're new to this channel, I'm going to say, I built this channel on the breakout pullback setup. Okay. When I first started recording my trading sessions, that's all I was taking. That's all I was taking was breakout pullback entries. But you know, I like I'm gonna start calling it the Last Kiss, right? That just the Last Kiss, that just has a better little ring to it, don't it? I know it's the breakout pullback entry. The study and I was doing it, they named it the Last Kiss, and I kind of like that name. So we're probably gonna start calling it the Last Kiss, but for me it's a breakout pullback entry. And so it's funny how you develop as a trader. You know, the more experience you have, the more you trade. Because what initially attracted me to the Last Kiss trade is that I didn't like taking range fades. believe it or not, as much as I promote range fade trading now, in the beginning, I did not like taking range fade setups. It was like, as soon as I would take the fade, it would break out. Ain't that crazy? Like, most people can't pick the breakout. I had the opposite problem. I would always pick the breakout when I wanted it to continue to range, right? And so some things, you know, we actually, in trading especially, I think it's a normal human situation too, but we program ourselves very easily. What I mean by that is this: if I show you a range fade setup and the first time you take it, it works, you now just have this belief system that it works and you're going to continue to look for that setup, all right? If I show you a breakout pullback entry the first time and it doesn't work, you're going to be like, ah, that don't work. Maybe I just stick to range fades, you know? So the first few times that I was doing range fades, they weren't working. They just didn't work for me. So I actually started to focus on breakout pullback entries. And so, but then as time has went on, I love range fades, right? So I guess what I'm kind of saying right here is just as a side note story is give each setup a legitimate shot. You know, just because it doesn't work the first time you take it doesn't mean it's not a good setup. Okay, you have to give these setups time. You know, maybe you didn't draw the support and resistance right. Maybe it had already had 22 touches at the top and bottom and it was just time to break out, you know. So you never know. But that was my story in the beginning. I'm just gonna was scared of range fades and I would wait for the breakout, and I got real good at actually picking when it was gonna break out. And so if you don't know, here, I can just tell you how the trade goes. It's a very simple trade. You find a range, right? And then you wait for it to break out. I mean, that's the last kiss in a gist. But what it is you find a range. And so because I was steady finding range and just watching how the market moved in ranges, I actually got pretty good at telling and being able to tell when it was going to break out. Because the market, you know, when you just really sit and watch prices print to a price chart, you start to see when there's momentum, right? And so there would be times where I'll be seeing it hit the top, it hit the bottom, it hit the top, it hit the bottom. But maybe on that last touch at the bottom, it surged up real hard, real fast, you know, where you could just visually see that, okay, that move up had a lot more momentum than the last three I watched, right? That would be the first clue that, hey, when this one gets to the top, it might could break out, right? And or if it's shooting up and the 21 EMA is real close now, like it's not in the center of the range, but the 21 EMA is up close to the top. That's another little clue that, you know what, this thing might just break out the top this time because the EMA is so close to it. The average price is higher to the top of the range, right? And so as you just gain more experience trading, you know, you will actually get better at picking when a breakout could possibly happen. But here's the key to taking breakout trades and actually winning them consistently. You have to wait. That's the key in a nutshell. You have to be patient, right? The first candle, say this is the top, the first candle that breaks out, you do not take that candle. You just, under no circumstances do you take the first candle. Because here's the rule, here's the general rule: most breakouts fail. Okay, so, and that's why most breakout trading strategies don't work, okay? Because most breakouts fail. But on the other side of that coin, the market has to start trending sooner or later, right? It can be choppy and rangy for a long time or a short time, but eventually it does have to break out, all right? So if you have the patience to wait for it, then you can take it. So this is I don't know if there's any trade that you have to be more patient for. This trade actually requires a lot of patience, but the payoff in many, many instances is worth the patience, especially if you're trading futures or Forex. If you're taking this setup in futures or Forex, the payoff is well worth it, because if you catch a breakout out of a range, you just caught the beginning of a new trend. All right. And so that means you may get a trend up, trend break, retest a new high. I mean, so you, that may be a 10 in futures. That may be a 10, 20, 30 point run. Or in the Forex, you know, that may be 100 pips, 200 pips. So in those two markets, this setup is very profitable, but you have to be patient, okay? So you don't take that first break. What you want to do is wait for the market to come up, come back. So that's why I call it a breakout pullback. And then you want a good signal candle that bounces off the top of that range, going in the direction that you expect. That's when you enter. So that's why I call it a breakout pullback entry. Now, in the study, and I was doing it, they called it the last kiss, because they're saying you break out and then the market comes back to test that area one more time, gives it one little last kiss, and then it's off to the races. So however you want to coin it, it's the same setup. All right. It's the same setup, but you wait. You have to be patient enough, because it's hard when you see that huge candle breaking. Everything in you is going to say go now. All right. I mean, you've been waiting. It's happening. You want to grab every pip. You want to grab every point. Don't do it. Don't do it. The setup is to wait for it to come back and retest that breakout area, that range, that top of that range, at least once. You gotta wait for it to come back and test it. And you'll be amazed. I mean, you'll be amazed at how much money you will save. You'll be amazed at how many winning trades you can rack up if you're patient enough to wait, okay? So like I said, if you go back to some of my oldest videos, man, I built this channel. The foundation of this channel was built on this setup, because I was just trading this setup. And for those who don't know, when I first started on YouTube, I didn't start to train anybody. I didn't start to teach anybody. I was trying to record my own trades to make myself accountable, to not overtrade, to make sure I wasn't getting cheated by brokers. So I decided to start recording my trades, and I just uploaded them on YouTube. That was it. I had no other, that was it. Okay. Everything else that's happened is just like Yahuwah had a plan that I had no idea about. I was just uploading videos to hold myself accountable. And people start asking me like, hey man, you know, great setup. Can you tell me more about it? Or people started subscribing. People started asking questions. And it was all about that breakout pullback entry. So that breakout pull, this trade, this setup right here that I'm teaching today, you know, it's the reason why I'm here. You guys loved it back then. Hopefully you like it today. And so I'm going to go to some charts so we can see if we can find it. Now here's the other, thing too. Now, if you're in the binary options market, the beauty of this setup is that the reason I was able to build this channel from the setups because I was trading binary and I was able to actually find this setup every day. All right. Now, if you're in futures or in Forex, you maybe could find it every day. Maybe futures, you ain't finding it every day. But in binary options, I used to go out and just scan assets till I found a range. Then it was just a waiting game, wait for it to break out. So that's the benefit of binary options. And I always hold this benefit in high regard because it's what makes binary options unique to every other market. You can trade the exact market condition you want to. Okay. So if you only want to take breakout trades, you can do that in the binary option market every day, right? If you only want to take range fades, you can do that every day in the binary options market. If you only want to take second entries or higher lows or lower highs or rally based rallies, that's the beauty of binary options. You know, there is so many assets that you can scan through and find the exact market conditions. Catch that? The exact market conditions you need, because you can't find a breakout strategy in a trending market. It's already trending. You've already missed the breakout, right? So you have to be able to spot this stuff. So we're gonna go some charts today. Hopefully I can find one, a good example for you guys, because the markets have been trending lately. Hopefully we can find a good example. But just so you know, the last kiss trade is simple. Box up a range, wait for a breakout. Do not take the first candle. Wait for prices to retest, test the breakout area. If you get a good signal candle back in the direction of the breakout, now you have a trade. Okay. Now, if you're trading Forex or futures, you put an emergency stop halfway in the range. All right. Typically, that stop ain't going to get hit. All right. But if prices come back in the range at all, you exit the trade at a small loss. That's the complete way to take the trade. Your profit target, if you're in futures or Forex, is the next zone of resistance. Okay. Binary options, hey, it's just kind of how you want it. It's really a higher low entry at that point. You could take it at 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, you know, whatever you normally trade for your expiration time. Is what you would do if you're in the binary options market. All right. So let's go over to some charts and see if we can find a great crispy example. All right. Let's go to the charts. If you want to learn price action trading, you can visit www.jdhyder.com, where you will find the IOTS price action trading system, which is the course that you need to begin to increase on the sudden. Okay, guys, we're on the charts. I think I may have found a little candidate here looking at this dollar Swiss. Let's see. You know, if I was trading this, I would have said this was the top pretty much here. Got one touch, missed the touch, got another touch there. Yeah, we can call that the top. And then the bottom of the range would be here. We got a few touches here. This is the bottom. Okay. So if I blow this up, it's like this. So typically, let me get my tool together. Okay, got my drawing tool together. So like I was saying earlier, you know, this is about patience. because we got this trend, right? You're gonna wanna go on this candle right here. When this candle breaks out of the range, most people would be like, oh, it's go time, you know. Right here, this puppy breaks out, you're gonna wanna go. Gonna wanna go right here, but it's not time yet. It's not time yet. You have to wait for a pullback. And this is a classic example. Now it didn't run out far, but you know, I may not find a better example today, but this is a breakout. Then it pulled back, it tested, it caught rejection right here. And then you got a beautiful signal candle back out, right? So you go here, all right? You go here on this candle. And like I said, if you're in futures and Forex, your emergency stop loss would be up here somewhere. It would be in the center of the range, all right? And then you just watch it. If it was to come back in here at all, you would just close out for a small loss, right? This is the emergency stop, small loss. That's only if it comes back. But as you see in this case, you would have been entering at the beginning of a great drop. I mean, if this was futures, man, you talking about a 20 pointer right there. That's a 25 point hit right there. If you're talking Forex, that's what, guys, at least 100, all right? If not 200, right? And if you're talking binary options, 3 minutes works, 5 minutes works, 10 minutes works, 20 minutes work. I mean, so the breakout pullback entry, or I guess I should say last kiss, it's an outstanding trade when taken correctly, okay? But you don't want to take this, you know, because you don't, you got to wait for the breakout pullback because most trends fail. Prime example right here. It broke, let's look at it going long. If you had a thought it was going to break out the top and went right here, let me get an arrow and change the color. If you had a went right here on this breakout, hey, that's a loss, right? That's a big loss. Even if your stop was down here, that's a loss because you got the breakout. You got the pullback, but it didn't break back higher again past this level, you know? So this one does. See the difference how this candle broke lower and everything here? You never got that break here. This one might've tripped you up a little bit, but here's why you don't take this, because it never really pulled back good. This you can't consider pullback. This was just still all out. Then this is the pullback. And then here you don't go because it didn't break back out the range. You didn't get higher than this level, so you don't go. Okay, that keeps you safe. But if you go here just thinking that, oh yeah, I got a breakout, not many binary options, 3 minutes, you win. 5 minutes, it came back for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, it would have came back for you. Futures and Forex, you get demolished, right? You get demolished. So where you have to remember the rule, most breakouts fail. So you have to have a good breakout pullback entry. And this entry here was crispy because the signal candle broke lower than all this, all right? Let me see if I can find a long example. Okay, I think I got a long example here on Microsoft. So let's say we saw this top right here. We got several touches, it's probably even more like this, but actually I'm gonna put it here. We got 3 touches right there. Then let's grab another one, put it to the bottom here. I mean, I could say we'll call that the bottom. Quite a few touches here, all right? So you're going to want to go right here. Oh, hold on, change the color back to yellow again. You're going to want to go right here, but it's just not time yet. You know, it's just not time yet. This is the breakout candle. You don't go here, you wait for a pullback. Now in this case, this is a breakout. Here's the pullback. This boy couldn't even get to the top of the range zone. Also, it bounced off the EMA. It closed a little higher than this one. Now, you could wait till it clears all this, but I actually do like entering right here on this one because it was so close to bouncing right off the range. but it bounced right off the 21 EMA. So you already know, you, this thing is already in the trend. I mean, like, if it's already above the 21 EMA, hey, the trend has actually already started. In this case, the trend actually did start back here. So once you break out of these, once you clear these highs, you wait and go right here, boom, you in there. So again, you'll stop. If you're in futures or Forex, you'll stop. Your emergency stop will be in the center here. If prices would have came back in this zone at all, you would have just exited right here for a small loss. But in this case, again, that's what, a 10, 15 point futures run. That's a cool 100 in Forex. And binary options, 1, 2, 3, that's a win. 5's a win, 10's a win, 20's a win. Hey, this setup is money, all right? when you take it correctly. And like I said, you know, earlier in the video, you know, this YouTube channel right here really exists because of this setup. And I used to find this setup all the time. It's so amazing in the binary options market. When you focus on one setup, it's amazing how often you can find that setup. Like, I mean, there's plenty of setups out here. There's second entries, there's higher lows, there's range fades, but it's amazing. Whatever you're focusing on, that's why I've been recently telling people, hey, just pick one trade. Just pick one trade and stick with it for 30, 60 days and see how you do. You know, because when you have that laser focus that, hey, I'm only taking this setup, it's amazing how often you will see the setup, and many times you will be happy with your win rate. You know, you'll be happy with your success rate just because you're getting so many reps in taking that very same setup. Okay, so I hope this helps somebody out. This is a great setup if you needed a new setup, but this is the proper way to trade breakouts. Okay, most breakout strategies fail. This is the only breakout strategy that I'm aware of that works at a very high percentage. All right. So, hey, welcome to the Last Kiss Trade. Give it a try. You know, try it out on demo first. And if you like it, give it 30 days, you know, and then if it makes you money, give it another 30, right? Hey, why break a winning trade? So this was the trade. Like I said, this is a trade I should take it all the time. You know, and then as I got more experience and stopped being scared of the ranges, you know, I started to take these boys and, you know, make money a little bit faster. Because like I said, you got to be patient for this setup. You have to wait for it. But as you can see, if you wait for it and take it properly, it's well worth the wait. All right, so that's going to wrap it up for me today. This is a great time to like, share, and subscribe. I greatly appreciate you guys. Yeah, until next time, my name is JD, and as always, I wish you increase on the sudden. Bye-bye. Don't be lazy in learning. Learn more price action. Check out this video right here.